Welcome back to Amicus Curiae, and as promised, we're now joined by Uday Ved, tax partner at KNAV, and he's going to dissect some of the key expectations that corporate India as well as individual taxpayers have from the government's panel. And this is a panel that was set up to relook at the direct tax system in the country and adopt international best practices, also keeping in mind the economic realities of the country. We believe and we understand that this panel might be reconstituted, but nevertheless, we thought that it's important to highlight what's the mood on the ground and what are some of the key expectations. So, Uday, let's kickstart with asking you about the corporate tax rate. You know, the corporate tax rate has been a rate that has always come under the scanner, budget after budget. It is widely believed, at least in corporate circles and the CA circles, that India has amongst the largest corporate tax rates or the highest corporate tax rates in the world. What do you think the approach of the government panel should be when it comes to dealing with the corporate tax rate?
Okay, thanks Ashwin first for the opportunity on this. Just coming to your question, Ashwin, you know, the entire world is competing for the capital, foreign capital, right, and investment. And of course, you know, the business is done based on the merits of the project and everything else. But tax certainly enters as one of the key aspects when one takes into account, you know, in terms of the business. And corporate tax rate, if one recollects, Finance Minister did promise in the budget of 2015 to reduce the base rate from 30 to 25% over a four-year period. Now, some aspect on the small and medium enterprises up to a turnover of 250 crores has been done and brought the rate to 25%. It still needs to be done for the larger corporates. The question which will remain would be whether this, you know, when as and when the rate is done from 30 to 25, is that the competitive rate? That's the first question. Second, you always try and add this in the form of surcharge. So the effective tax rate today is not 30, it is 35% of the highest rate. And that is certainly a very high rate compared to the global scenario. If one just looks at, say, USA, where it believed that the tax rate of 35% base rate was very high. Here comes President Trump as a part of his campaign, and he said that he's going to do a major tax reform. The US tax reform last was done was in 1986. He comes here within 6 months of he being on the power, he introduces a new US tax reform, and the base rate of 35% has been reduced to 21%. Now that's a significant tax rate cut as far as US is concerned. And that also means that you know, a lot of business, a lot of projects and businesses may move into US. That's one of the key objectives. So 21 really is a major tax cut rate from a US perspective. If one looks at UK, it is sub 20. It will go to 16 or 17 in a very short while of time. In Asia, the tax rates are sub 20%. And so I think even a 25% base rate remains, and you know, if you first need to remove the surcharge, 25% in my view also is going to be a high rate. The average tax rate, as you know, the finance minister has gone on record and everyone knows, is about 20 to 23%. So I think first objective would be to reduce from 30 to 25 as soon as possible. We already reduced all the tax incentives and everything to make the tax you know, rate simple. And so the base rate of 25 has to be done. That is one part. But I would believe that it should actually further go down to 20%. And that would really make India competitive purely from a tax perspective.
Right. Uday, it's also widely believed by the government authorities that there still needs to be far greater penetration as far as the tax base is concerned. And it's believed that despite demonetization, which has led to a great spurt in the number of filing of returns, you know, there is still a vast portion of perhaps even smaller corporates and maybe even individuals that are not yet covered by the direct tax law. What do you think the government panel can do to widen the tax base across corporates as well as individual taxpayers?
I think this is a very important question, Ashwin. What you are saying is, one thing is a tax rate, right? Here, if you look at the compliance, you know, and again, the finance minister has gone on record and everyone knows about it. India is one of the most non-tax compliant countries in the world. You know, if you look at individual tax compliance, hardly 5% of the people would be in the tax net. So certainly a government has to do, and this is an issue for last several decades, and no change with the current government either. The tax rate, rather than tax rate, once the tax base has to be expanded significantly. Government has done some effort in the past in terms of the black money law and amnesty and everything. It has not really yielded beyond a point much result, except that the tax base has gone up a little bit from 3 to 5% or plus. One major change, Ashwin, that has happened in last 1 year is the introduction of GST. Now, GST is supposed to bring, of course, because of the way entire credit mechanism, input credit mechanism works, is to bring all the turnover into the books. So the one major beneficial impact of GST is that the turnover, all the sales and turnover will come in the books, which we have seen in last 1 year. We are already more than 1 year in GST. And that itself is bringing more income tax on account of the sales which have been. So this is one major part which has happened. A lot more needs to be done on that. I think what needs to be done is the use of technology. And this government is committed. We are seeing more and more use of technology, connecting dots at various places, match and mismatch in terms of the expenditure incurred by individuals and corporates compared to the income that they are showing it. The use of technology will bring, a major this thing, coupled with a simplification and more moderate tax rate. Right. So if you have a moderate tax rate of, going to 20% for corporates or 25, between 20 and 25%, and an individual tax rate, 30% looks to me like, to start with an okay income tax rate, remove all the surcharge, I think, make it investor friendly.
Would they share your thoughts on litigation? You advised several high profile clients when it comes to litigation in the past, tax litigation in the past. There are several areas wherein we have seen a huge spurt in terms of litigation, especially in the area of transfer pricing. What would your key expectation from the panel be in terms of measures that have to be adopted and implemented to curb litigation, to curb tax litigation?
With the relationship between India and US improving, we have seen more and more bilateral applications being done. And government, I think, has already issued more than 200 APAs, as I understand. So that's one part. An APA regime needs to be encouraged more. More and more benches need to be set up, because I think it also all boils down to, whereas the authorities are very pragmatic and willing and objective to listen to it, more and more benches need to be set up, more and more applications need to be taken into consideration, and the need for completing the APA process can be then reduced to an extent. So this is one part. On the tax litigation, one has seen in terms of filing the appeals for domestic tax litigation, the limit of certain corporates have been increased to say that unless it is a recurring in nature, the tax department will not go and file the appeal. So one has to also see the cost benefit analysis ratio. More can be done on that. Is there a way to settle past litigation? India has never believed on the tax litigation negotiation, but can there be one kind of an amnesty scheme or a settlement scheme that can be introduced in one budget, like we introduced for the black money? Can we not do it for the tax litigation, to say that you come together, pay a reasonable rate, and then close the litigation? The government did try to do that in case of litigation like Vodafone, but it has not yielded result, because I think the practical aspect of that scheme could not be implemented. But I think a more friendly scheme for a one-time settlement, I think, could be an idea that one can throw into it. The last part I would say, which is again never there in the statute, is there a negotiated settlement possible on a recurring basis, or which I believe is not, the government has never thought about it. But these are some of the aspects that one could see to reduce first the past litigation, and going forward give more certainty and reduce the tax rate, base rate, so that the litigation on that can be reduced in future.
Right, Uday, the government also wants this panel to take a leaf out of some of the international best practices, some of the practices in tax that have been taken up and implemented successfully by overseas jurisdictions. Can you give us an example of perhaps a few jurisdictions where India could lean on and perhaps implement their policies successfully on the ground back home?
So, interesting, you know, at least on the tax avoidance front, there was this BEPS measure, the base erosion and profit shifting measure, which is an initiative of G20 and OECD, which has been taken into consideration, and India is one of the key signatories. BEPS recommendations have been implemented by India is another top radar. We have seen, the transfer pricing recommendations on CBCR and master file and others. We also seen the limitation of interest deduction, which have been put in. So, on a tax, again, the treaty renegotiation we have seen. So, by and large, I think India has been really done good on the BEPS recommendation that avoids the tax litigation. Second, if you look at the other best practices which we spoke about, the tax rate, and if you really want to make India competitive, the base rate of tax with certainty is really one aspect. And take an example of US, right? It took this decision in 6 months, implemented the law. Here we have the DTC, which we have been speaking since 2009, almost a decade. It has gone back and forth on various aspects. We have to have a time-bound implementation. I think that is going to be really creating a much more confidence in the taxpayers rather than, you know, just delaying it. And what happens, you know, we've spent so much time, effort, energy on the DTC. Government is keen to make it happen, to make it simplify the tax law. And we need to have this time-bound measure to implement it. And the last part I would put it is this entire tax administration, right? Can you make it more administration friendly, reduce litigation? We have seen some of this part. We've seen more and more interaction between the taxpayers and tax authorities in last few years. That needs to be increased much more. And, you know, like I am in my consulting business and I have my clients. I treat my clients as my clients. Can government look at taxpayers as own clients, I think. And I think that would really change in the approach. We've seen that good approach. Incentivize the honest taxpayer and disincentivize or penalize the dishonesty. I think if it does that, engagement with the taxpayers, I think would be a good idea to do that.
Right, one last question. We are waiting eagerly to see what the next step of the government would be and when this task force for the direct tax law gets reconstituted. Hypothetically speaking, if it does get reconstituted and the committee submits their proposals, because there's been a delay already, do you think they'll really get adopted next year, considering it's election time?
I have my doubts, Ashwin. Okay. And this was the time, if it would have been done, although it would have got implemented post-elections, because you now only have an interim budget, be it in February or whenever, 1st February, when that happens. So all the recommendation which will come, it will get into the new government, and one would see how the new constitution takes place. But irrespective of the government, I think the recommendations, if it is tax friendly and it is to the benefit of the country, then I don't see any reason why it should not be implemented. Like the first DTC was done in the prior regime, right? This government continued, and whatever happens post-election, if the recommendations are in the right interest of the economy and the taxpayers, then it should be implemented, but only the time will prove.
Uday Ved, thanks so much for taking our time and sharing your perspective. Always a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Amicus Curiae. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Ashwin Mohan signing off. I'll see you next week.